Good morning, students. Hope you must have enjoyed your long vacations. Today, we'll be starting our 10th standard portion. We'll start with this Science and Technology First, Chapter Number 5, Heat. In this, the learning goals are latent heat, anomalous behavior of water, regulation, dew point and humidity, and specific heat capacity. So what is heat? Last year in 9th standard we have studied what is heat. Heat is nothing but a form of energy and it is measured by thermometer. So what's the difference between heat and temperature? Again, heat is nothing but a molecular total energy of a molecular motion in a substance. On the contrary, temperature is measure of the average energy of molecular motion in a substance. Now we'll study the concept of latent heat. What is latent heat? For this, we are going through a small experiment. In this experiment, you can see a beaker. In this beaker, we have taken ice cubes. In ice cubes, we have dipped a inserted a thermometer. And you can observe there is a burner. As you start the burner, the heat will be provided, given to the ice cubes, and the ice cubes will start melting. As the ice cube starts melting, still you cannot observe this readings or any readings on the thermometer. Still you go on continuously supplying the heat, the ice will melt completely into water. You will observe from this experiment, you will observe that the temperature of the mixture remains 0 degrees Celsius till the ice melts completely. If we continue heating this, even after conversion of all the ice into water, the temperature of water then starts showing, the thermometer will show the readings and it will reach to 100 degrees Celsius. At this temperature, this water will start converting into steam. But again, though we are providing the heat, the temperature from the thermometer will show 100 degrees Celsius. If you draw the graph from this readings, you will observe that this AB, you can see here AB, represents the conversion of ice into water at constant temperature. And this constant temperature at which the ice completely gets converted into water is called melting point of ice. The line BC in the graph shows the rise in temperature of water from 0 degrees Celsius to 100 degrees Celsius. At again, at this place, when the solid state converted into liquid and the liquid starts converting into gaseous state, at 100 degrees Celsius, again the temperature remains constant. It do not change though you supply the heat, till it get completely converted from liquid to gaseous state. That temperature at which the liquid substance get completely converted to gaseous state is called boiling point of water. Here, the constant temperature at which ice converts into water is called melting point of ice. So we have already seen in this previous experiment. In this experiment, we have already seen we are supplying the heat continuously, but still thermometer do not show any change in the readings. Why this happens? Where this heat goes? So this heat is used to break or first weaken the bonds between the ice or the solid substances which we are using here. This hidden heat is called latent heat of fusion. And when this here, when this the water gets converted into water vapors, again there is no change in the readings. So again here, though we are providing heat, but it do not shows on the thermometer. That time again, this heat, hidden heat, is called latent heat of vaporization. It is used to break the molecules between the bonds between the molecules from liquid to change the phase of liquid state to gaseous state. Yeah, boiling point of the liquid, the constant temperature at which the liquid transforms into gaseous state is called boiling point of the liquid. Latent heat of vaporization is nothing but the heat energy absorbed at constant temperature during transformation of liquid into gas is called latent heat of vaporization. And specific latent heat of vaporization is nothing but the amount of heat energy absorbed at constant temperature by unit mass of a liquid to convert into gaseous phase is called specific latent heat of vaporization. The different substances are having different melting points and boiling points, and the values of the melting point and boiling point and latent heat depends on atmospheric pressure, and here it is shown in this table. Now second point which we are going to study is regulation. What is regulation? You must have eaten so many times, you must have ate ice ball. Have you observed how they form? What they do? They shred the ice slab and then they pressurize it and stick it on the stick to form a ball. How it happens? Now to understand this, we are going to study an activity. In this activity, what we have taken? We have taken a table. On this table, we kept an ice slab, and on this slab, we put a metallic wire, and at both the ends of the metallic wire, we tied the weights. Now, what happens if you observe this? Due to this pressure applied by the weight, the ice melts and gets converted into water. And as it gets converted into water, the metallic wire passes through this ice slab. As it passes through the ice slab, again the water converted into ice. Why this happens? This happens due to phenomenon of regulation. So what is phenomenon of regulation? It is nothing but when the pressure is applied on the ice, its melting point decreases below 0 degrees Celsius, and when you remove this pressure again, it restored the melting point at 0 degrees Celsius. And that's why when you apply the weights, it applies the pressure, and as it applies the pressure, the melting point lowers below 0 degrees Celsius. As it lowers below 0 degrees Celsius, ice converted to water. Then the metallic wire passes through the water, and again as the pressure is removed, again the melting point is restored to 0 degrees Celsius, and the water can get converted into ice. And that's how this metallic wire passes through the ice slab but do not break into two. That is due to phenomenon of regulation. First we'll start with anomalous behavior of water. In general, whenever we supply heat to any substance, it expands and then up to a certain temperature, it expands, and when cool, it contracts. Water, however, shows a special and exceptional behavior. When we heat water from 0 degrees Celsius to 4 degrees Celsius, instead of expanding, it contracts. At 4 degrees Celsius, its volume is minimum. And if the water is heated further, it expands and its volume increases. the behavior of water between its temperature from 0 degrees Celsius to 4 degrees Celsius is called anomalous behavior of water. Now, if you can observe this in graph, see here, from 0 to 4 degrees Celsius, as the temperature increases, the water, instead of expanding, it contracts, means volume goes on decreasing. The volume becomes minimum at 4 degrees Celsius. After 4 degrees Celsius, as the temperature increases, the volume also goes on increasing. Now we'll study the anomalous behavior of water using Hope's apparatus. If you see this Hope's apparatus, what you can see? You can see a cylinder in the middle. Then you can see a outer bowl and attachment of the two thermometers. Now in this cylinder, you can fill water. Then in outer bowl, you can put freezing mixture. It is nothing but the mixture of salt and ice. And then you can insert thermometer T1 in the lower part and thermometer T2 in the upper parts of Hope's apparatus. Now how it works, how we can observe whatever observation we can see, how we can explain it. Initially, the temperature of the water in the cylinder is same, and in the middle of the cylinder lowers. Now here, this is the middle part where the freezing mixture is kept. So initially what will happen, due to this freezing mixture, the water which is present in this part of the cylinder, it will lowers. As it goes down, the temperature goes down, its density increases. And as the density increases, it will settle down at the bottom of the cylinder. Till 4 degrees, this phenomenon will occur till all the water will attain the same temperature, that is 4 degrees Celsius. So only this thermometer, in the beginning, only thermometer T1 will show fall in temperature. After that, attaining 4 degrees Celsius, as we know, anomalous behavior of water, if it further falls below 4 degrees Celsius, instead of now contracting, it will start expanding. As it expands, the volume increases. As the volume increases, density decreases. And as the density decreases, this water will start moving in an upward direction. And then when it starts moving in upward direction, this thermometer T2 will start showing the change in fall in temperature till 0 degrees Celsius. And then, but at that time, this temperature T1, that is thermometer T1, will show the same temperature 4 degrees Celsius for a while. And after some time, it will also show the fall in temperature and attain 0 degrees Celsius. You can observe this from this time and temperature graph. In the beginning, T1 and T2 both are at the same temperature. Then the T1 starts falling till 4 degrees Celsius. After that, when it attains 4 degrees Celsius, T2 will start falling. And then afterward, both will attain 0 degrees Celsius. Then anomalous behavior of based on anomalous behavior of water, we can explain how the animals in cold climate survive, animals as well as plants in cold climate survive when the atmospheric temperature goes below 0 degrees Celsius. Again, same thing happens here. Based on anomalous behavior of water, we can explain how this aquatic plant and animal survive in cold region during winter. What happens, as we know, the anomalous behavior of water, so instead of contracting, it expands till 4 degrees Celsius. And as here, what happens, when the density becomes minimum at 4 degrees Celsius, at that time this temperature remains at 4 degrees Celsius at the bottom of the water reservoirs. And after 4 degrees, below 4 degrees Celsius, as the temperature falls, instead of contracting, it starts expanding. And as it expands, the water starts moving at the surface of the water reservoir. At 0 degrees Celsius, the water turns to ice. And as it turns to ice, the layer of the ice is formed on the surface of this water reservoir. As ice being a bad conductor of heat, it do not allow this heat which is present in the water reservoir to go out of this water reservoir. And that's how this aquatic plant and animals remain at 4 degrees Celsius, they do not freeze and they survive in the cold region or during the winter seasons.